says the way I feel. When it's real, I keep it alive. The road is long. There are mountains in our way, but we climb a stair every day. Love lifts us up where we belong, where the eagles cry on the mountain high. Love lifts us up where we belong, far from the world below. Looking behind,
all we have is here and now. All our lives are there to find.
The road is long. There are mountains in our way, but we climb a step every day. Love lifts us up where we belong, where the eagles cry on a mountain high. Love lifts us up where we belong, far from the world. Time goes by, no time to cry. Last you and I alive. Day.
We're gathered here today to witness and celebrate the marriage of Shaun Maguire and Debbie Harty. Both Shaun and Debbie have requested that we conduct a simple and very loving and personal ceremony, so I hope that's what it will be. You can tell me afterwards. Okay. Marriage is a joining of two people in a life bond formed from the mutual love they have for each other. It's a partnership that involves love and respect, and it carries with it a commitment to share all of their hopes, their responsibilities, and to care for each other's happiness, aspirations and comfort. It's a commitment to become a single entity whilst allowing and encouraging each other to be happy and independent. I, Shaun Patrick Maguire,
I, Shaun Patrick Maguire,
solemnly declare,
solemnly declare,
that I know of no lawful reason,
that I know of no lawful reason,
why I may not be joined,
why I may not be joined,
in marriage,
in marriage,
to Deborah Jane Harty.
Deborah Jane Harty.
I, Deborah Jane Harty,
I, Deborah Jane Harty,
solemnly declare,
solemnly declare,
that I know of no lawful reason,
that I know of no lawful reason,
why I should not be joined,
why I should not be joined,
in marriage,
in marriage,
to Shaun Patrick Maguire.
To Shaun Patrick Maguire.
Okay. I spent some time chatting to Shaun and Debbie to plan today's ceremony, and I asked each of them a very simple question. Why have you chosen Debbie to be your life partner, and why have you chosen Shaun? Now, I kept them apart when I was asking the question. I have here what they both said, but they haven't discussed it with one another. So this will be the first time you hear it, and the first time they hear it. Okay. I finally tracked down Shaun. He's not the easiest of guys to get on the telephone. He's either asleep or he's at work. And this is what Shaun told me. Debbie and I have been together for 7 years. Debbie's a great mum and we have two smashing children. I personally made the choice to get married, as we've stayed together through loads of problems. And we feel that as a married couple, we can handle anything that the future throws at us. Oh, and I love her to bits. This is what Debbie told me. I knew from the very first minute that I wanted to be with Shaun for the rest of my life. Shaun makes me smile when no one else can. He makes me weak at the knees. There you go, gents. I can always rely on him to back me up. He always fights my corner. Shaun is a great partner and a great dad, and I love him dearly. Hugh, could we have the rings now, please? We did check which pocket beforehand. Lovely. This is really the point where Shaun wishes that he'd been born in Roman times. Wedding rings were then made of iron. Which is interesting. The cheap Romans. These rings are an external symbol of the vows that Shaun and Debbie have made to each other. The circle symbolises their never-ending love and commitment. Shaun, will you please place your ring on Debbie's finger and repeat after me. Debbie. I place this ring on your finger.
I place this ring on your finger.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my never-ending love.
My never-ending love.
Debbie. Please place the ring on Shaun's finger and repeat after me. Shaun. I place this ring on your finger.
I place this ring on your finger.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my never-ending love.
Of my never-ending love.
Oh, go on.
Lovely. Smashing. Thank you. We now move to the formal vows required by the laws of Scotland. And these are agreed with the couple and written word for word, so I'm not allowed to deviate. So I will speak the vows, and if you're happy, Shaun, you just say, I do. Okay. Do you, Shaun Patrick Maguire, take Deborah Jane Harty to be your wife, to be her constant friend, her partner in life, and her true love, to love her without reservation, and to respect her, protect her from harm, comfort her in times of distress, and to grow with her in mind and spirit.
Okay.
Do you, Deborah Jane Harty, take Shaun Patrick Maguire to be your husband, to be his constant friend, his partner in life and his true love, to love him without reservation, to respect him, protect him from harm, comfort him in times of distress, and to grow with him in mind and spirit?
I do.
Thank you. By the authority invested in me by the laws of Scotland, I now declare you husband and wife. Shaun, you may now kiss your bride. May the sun bring you new energies by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away any worries you may have, and the breeze blow new strength into your being. And then, all the days of your life, may you walk gently through the world and know its beauty. Thank you on behalf of Debbie and Shaun for being here and witnessing their marriage. We now come to the signing of the register.
You're still the one I love. Looks like we made it. Looks look how far we've come, my baby. We might have took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. You're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss good night. Ain't nothing better. We beat the odds together. I'm glad we didn't listen. Look at what we would be missing. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. You're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss goodnight. You're still the one.
We would all like to congratulate Debbie and Shaun. Well done.
Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun. We hope you have a wonderful day and a happy life together from London, Michelle.
Congratulations, Shaun and Debbie. I hope you have a good life together. Love yous.
Congratulations, Mum and Daddy. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun. Hope you have a fantastic day and a wonderful and long and happy life together.
Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun.
Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. McGuire. You have a lovely, wonderful life together.
Me too. Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun.
Congratulations.
Congratulations!
Congratulations, Shaun and Debbie. Hope you have a long and successful marriage.
Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun.
Congratulations to Shaun and Debbie.
Hi Debbie, hi Shaun. Congratulations. Looking forward to a really good day and I wish you all the best.
Congrats.
Have a good day!
Congratulations, Debbie and Shaun.
Congratulations, Shaun and Debbie. Hope you have a great day. You're certainly going to have a great day. Hope you have a wonderful life together. Both of you look absolutely smashing with your kids. As again, have a good day. And let the drinking commence in the morning.
Love you!
Love you!
Congratulations for me, Adele, and the kids. Hope you have a long, joyous life together. I'm sure that we're all going to have a wonderful time. And if you don't, then that's down to yourself, because without the hearties, you have nobody.
You're right.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's an absolute privilege to have everybody here today. As the father of the bride, it gives me great delight to say a few words on behalf of Debbie. I'd like to start off by saying, on behalf of London myself, I'd like to welcome you all along here today, and everybody looks absolutely wonderful. I'd also like to thank Alice and Jim
and the rest of her family for joining together to celebrate such a special day in the celebration of Debbie and Sean's marriage. There's always a tough bit in any speech, and sadly the next bit is going to be a wee bit of a tearjerker for most of you. I won't.
No.
No. Hey, you better ask your sister for hankies.
I honestly, I can't let this moment pass without mentioning some people who are not with us today. And it's without a shadow of a doubt there would be nobody more prouder than Janie. This is very good. Absent friends who are not here today will also want to wish Debbie and Sean a wonderful and a happy life together. Time passes by so quickly, and if you think the first time that Debbie got dressed up, it's not today, Debbie, you're right. She was baptised. And throughout that service, Debbie did nothing but bawl and scream the whole day. And for 24 years then, never stopped. However, it's fair to say that you're no shrinking violet. I'm sure most of you in here today have experienced that. At school, Debbie was quite a madam.
Was she, wasn't
it? In fact, in many occasions, Debbie told the teachers, this is how we should do it. And she was always very quick to let her feelings known. However, the time came when Debbie decided it was time for her to start working. And as she did, under the guidance and the watchful eye of her Auntie Margaret, the Red Grill. Debbie was about 14 and could have, without a shadow of a doubt, run that floor like nobody else, Margaret. Agreed? And Margaret used to look up to her and say she's wonderful until she would be sitting having a cup of tea. And Debbie would say, what are you doing sitting drinking tea while I'm polishing a cup? She always had plenty to say. And I don't think that's ever going to change. Debbie has been described in many ways as a party animal. And you really need to see it to believe it. And I heard on one occasion that she was on holiday with Paul sitting there. And sadly she'd have put Paul to bed at 8:30. And she drank him under the table, which comes as no surprise. Anyway, she's a married woman now. As we all know, we've all watched, we've all accepted. And the days are over, Debbie.
Yep. Oh, I don't know about that.
And, good life. And on that note, we will all live in hope. And what we did do is I gave Debbie a duty, a major duty to carry out throughout the wedding arrangements, and that was to do the invitations.
No, I stay.
Hold on, I better take a drink for that one. And I said, in fact, I demand you to make sure that this is right. So, we have a Thursday club, which I'm sure Sarah and Paul and Liz and H will know all about. We go to our Mary's on a Thursday night, and I happen to see this lovely invitation. And I go and open it, and inside it's written in red pen. So I went back to
pen.
I went back to Debbie and I said, Debbie, red pen, blue, black, what was wrong? Oh, Dad, she said, see, the only demands that I get for letters, they're written in red. So I understand. Debbie's qualities is how obliging she is. She would run from here to hell without a question of a doubt. And that's what makes Debbie the person that she is. She is undoubtedly one of the most kindest, generous people that I've ever had the pleasure to know. No matter anybody sitting in this hall tonight who has ever asked Debbie to do something, you can be assured that Debbie will have done it and have been very happy to do it. In fact, she's taken penny cabs from being a 50 cab out 50 to 100 cab because of the amount of taxes she gets late night. She's also very well recognised in her own job, and she's always quick to offer her help to anybody who would like a day off or a night off. And I'm not sure that Debbie does it out of kindness. I think she just does it to get out of the house to see if I'm doing the work. Anyway, apart from our marriage to Shaun, the most memorable occasion, and it's not it's not because it's to be paid, because Debbie will without doubt be delighted to take the bill from the lovely Abigail there. Without blinking her eyes, she will say, "Dad, Jim, deal with that." That's how she does things. There's not a care in the world that she never does have, and I don't think she ever will have. But anyway, that's the reason why dads love their daughters, because what else could we say on that one? I need to watch, because I could cry very easy.
Don't do that, like you.
We've seen that earlier.
I know I'm a big guy, but listen, I've got a really poor heart.
Yeah.
Anyway, two outstanding achievements for Debbie's life is without a shadow of a doubt, Reese and Sophie.
Yay. Yay.
Two kids bring such great delight to both Linda and myself, and to Jim and Alice. They're fantastic kids. They're great. They're great fun. They're full of goodness. And without them, I don't know where we would be. But Debbie's the person who deserves all the praise for how well she's bringing them up, and how much attention she pays to them, and the high standards she works to. In fact, I would go to say that she's a wonderful mother. And of course, Shaun, I've got to say, son, you play a massive part in their life. You're very much influential. You're very much relaxed. You're laid back. Not that I'm saying that Debbie isn't. But without a shadow of a doubt, you play an absolutely wonderful role in both their lives. And they say that opposites attract. Oh my God. That statement was made on behalf of Debbie and Shaun. Hey. You're right, they both have got different natures, but they complement each other. With Debbie's strengths and Shaun's weakness. Sorry, the weaknesses that Debbie possesses, the strength that Shaun's got. Anyway, we hope that the both of you are very happy, along with the two kids, and long may that go on. Anyway, I don't want to talk for all day, you know that I can. But I was reminded of a lovely poem about newlyweds, which I'd like to quote. "Today is the beginning of a journey the two of you will share. You're vowed to love, honour and cherish, seen in the rings that you wear. And tomorrow, you'll wake up as husband and wife, or the person next to you is yours for life. And so may I wish you both that you wake each day, you will turn to each other and say, 'Oh, your breath's short.' No, I didn't say that. You'll share today. Ladies and gentlemen, the best compliment that I can pay and you can pay to Debbie and Shaun is to enjoy this fantastic occasion of their marriage. Let's make this wedding one to celebrate and enjoy. I know that that will make Debbie and Shaun's a really happy and memorable day. God bless you both always. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, please can you be upstanding and raise a toast to the bride and groom, to Debbie
and Shaun."
I do have a speech here, it's written on paper, it's not A4 printed like Eddie's or the wonderful best man over there. I'm just going to thank a few folk on behalf of my wife and I. also for the gifts and the cards, etc. I would like to thank Eddie for allowing me his daughter's hand in marriage. Also for that wonderful speech that I've just heard. I would like to thank both Eddie and Linda for everything they've done to make today what it is so special. Hold on a second.
On my speech,
at this point in the day, I would like to give a wee token of appreciation to both my mum and Linda, if we could do the honours. I would like to thank my best man, Shaun, sitting over the end there, for delivering me here in 1 week. I'm sure my wife, Debbie, will agree with me on that, obviously. I'd like to thank our Laura, obviously, as we've been made of honour. I know firsthand. Well done. I'm sure you all agree that my wife is looking absolutely phenomenal today. On that note, I would like everybody to raise a glass to my wife, to Debbie, to my wife.
Mrs. Maguire!
I'm glad I'm done. That's easy enough. Right now, I was passing over the best man, Shaun, who's sitting at the end there.
Well, I'd like to say good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Shaun. I'm an alcoholic. Stuff that leads me on to where I met Shaun and Debbie. Don't laugh. I met a lot of good friends at their meetings, by the way. Oh my God. I've known both Shaun and Debbie for many, many years, but I don't wish to give away my age when I'm looking so slick and trendy.
I'm looking no bad by you, by the way.
Thank you. I'm told the best man's speech should last as long as I do in bed. So get yourselves comfy, folks.
Can you clarify that?
Thank you. Beginning of one of the guys, by the way.
Well, I think it's apt to start where Shaun and Debbie had met. Well, Shaun and Debbie's first encounter was when they met at the Med Grill in Cole Bridge. They soon started dating, and I'm told they shortly after took up a keen interest in DIY. Word has it, they were banging and screwing for months.
I'd like to thank you.
To celebrate and marry Debbie and Shaun. May I say, Debbie, you look absolutely stunning today. I'd like to take this time to thank the parents of the bride and the groom for making this day possible. So if you would like to raise a glass to the parents of the bride and groom. I'd also like to take a moment to thank Laura, who are bridesmaids. So after being so nice, ladies and gents, I think it's about time to share a few of our embarrassing stories about our Shaun.
Next page.
I'm sure I've guessed The story involves a young lad at the time who struggled to drink like a big boy. And after missing his mouth most of the night, he continued by missing the toilet plan 7 fucking times. My personal favourite story with Shaun is when we all headed out for a classy night dancing at a disco in shorts at a time called Secrets. But it was no secret where Shaun ended up that night. After deciding he was not that great with bathroom carpets, he decided to relieve himself in the main street outside a busy disco. I chased the rumours after that. Of course, the police weren't got outside there. Anyway, however, the little policeman was very nice and informed Shaun that where he was going that night, there was no, he had his own bloody bathroom suite. That was the same. I heard it's traditional to offer some advice to the bride and groom as they embark on their journey together as husband and wife. So I'm not as great at these kind of things, so here goes. As they say on the wee boats of South Clyde Park, I hope he's never had a fall out. Some women may marry for love. Some women may marry for companionship. Debbie needs a new microwave.